All right. We're almost there. Almost there to that game. But that's next week. Right now, we got to focus on Iowa State. And they got to focus on Kansas. So, a much bigger challenge in Austin, mind you, in my opinion. I think they would agree. Because if we're honest about Iowa State, they're not a good football team. Just anemic on offense. They have a decent secondary. I'm supposed to be scared of the secondary. But this has always been like a look-ahead game for Oklahoma, like a trap game. So you go back in the past, and OU is like, what, 50-50 the past few years in a game like this? Thankfully, Iowa State, as I mentioned, not a good football team. You are very close to completing step one of the season, going 5-0 in September. I've always said this is a must, this is a need, this is something they desperately had to do to stay on pace to where you want to be as a football program. And so far, Oklahoma has done that. They've have looked pretty at times, but defensively, they've been very consistent. And I know everyone kind of waits for the other shoe to drop for OU when it comes to defense, but so far, they're one of the best in the nation right now. And they're extending that. Now, you could say it's based on the teams they played and so forth, but they played bad teams in the past and haven't been this good. Both run defenses are pretty strong, so whoever figures out how to run the football first is probably going to take control of the game for a little bit. My guess is Oklahoma. Savion Byrd is back. I don't know if he's going to start, but he might get the rotation. Just whatever Lebby needs to do to get the ball running, literally, to run the football. Gavin Sawchuk was tweeting out, you know, hints or something. He's like, maybe he had a good week of practice. I don't know. I don't need someone to necessarily emerge to be the guy, but a couple guys need to have more consistent games. I don't care what combo it is. If it's Javonte and Gavin, if it's Marcus Major and Tali Walker, Caleb Hicks and Dalen Smothers, I don't care who it is. You can mix them all up and give me two or three guys. Just give me someone who you know can, when the hole is open, they can take care of it and they can go for a big chunk. That's all I ask. But that's like the one thing that's been holding OU back just a little bit. The run game just hasn't been there. And hopefully, like, by pulling guards and tackles, like we did last week, things got going a little bit. But at the end of the day, we don't have a Kennedy Brooks who is just, we took for granted because who could just, like, find that open hole and can make plays happen. We don't have an Eric Gray who midseason, you know, established himself last year and kind of took control of the offense. At times felt like he was the offense. But this game is all about taking care of business. Don't get anyone hurt. I don't care if the score looks super pretty. I would like for you to cover, because OU has covered every game this year so far. Great teams cover. Elite teams cover. That's what Oklahoma's been doing so far. 20-point favorite last I checked. If you won this game 40-20, I'd be fine. I know everyone else would lose their minds, probably. 30-10, I don't care. Get in, get out with a W. I'm sure you'd like to see more guys on offense score, look at the offense, make it look pretty sure going into Red River. But for me, I just want to make sure no one gets hurt, get in, get out with the win. Because, like I said, regardless of how well we win, we're not going to impress anybody. No one's going to talk about us. They'll start talking about us a little bit next week, but we know what the discussion's really going to be about next week. It's going to be about Texas. They'll talk about us a little bit as, like, the first real test for the Longhorns in Big 12 play. You thought of... But, it's just, it's hard to not look past things. It's hard to not look forward to next week. As fans, we can do that. I always love it when fans tell their fans, don't look ahead to next week, as if we're on the field. As if, I better show up to practice this week and make sure that I hit the sleds. It's hard, because that's the first big game of the year. You've seen a lot of other teams have other big games, and you know, it's like, I want to be part of that. I want my team to be in a game like that. Well, that's coming up next Saturday, regardless of how either game turns out. Let's be honest. It'll still be a big game. But, you know, both teams take care of business. It'll be the first undefeated matchup since 2011, which we all know how that one turned out. 2008 was undefeated. 2004 was undefeated. So it's not very often both these teams meet with a zero in the loss column. So we'll know what Texas has done pretty much for the most part. We'll know if they're taking care of business or struggle by the time we kick off. But I wouldn't cry if they lost. But at the same time, there is something about you deep down inside that wants both those teams to be undefeated. You want game day to be there. You want the excitement around it because whoever wins that game is going to get a huge bump. And, you know, but again, take care of business against Iowa State. Quarterback play is mid. Running game is not quite there. Rush defense is good on both sides, I guess. It is a Matt Campbell team, so just don't take anything for granted. Hopefully they play their game, defense plays solid, and we move on to October. So, that being said, yeah, I can get ready for get on a plane next Friday, go to Dallas. Be interesting. So, a few things to take care of before I do that, but I will be here for the watch along tomorrow night. FS1 will leave the games on, and as long as I'm feeling good. If I'm not, I'll just cancel it. But so far, so good. So far, for the most part, this year. But that being said, you know, go win, Oklahoma. Go undefeated into Red River. That's all I ask. Boomer Sooner. Y'all have a good one.